Hello. It's almost a year since Georgie passed on the other show. The year has truly raced by, and we're yet to come to grips with the fact that Georgie is no longer around. All of it seems so unreal, like a bad dream. On the occasion of the first anniversary, we thought we'd put together a video. A video, because we are geographically distanced. A video to remember the exceptional persona and friend that Georgie was. So here we are. Oddly, the first time I met Georgie was almost 23 years ago as a client. There was a gentleman behind the desk looking quite steely, stony and stern. And I thought to myself, this is going to be a tough nut to crack. However, the toughness ended right there with his looks. Georgie in reality was quite a contrast. A perfect example of the phrase, never judge a book by its cover. I soon discovered that behind the stuff facade lay a heart of gold, a soft, squishy heart of gold. Someone who was ever willing to help, irrespective of who asked for it. I imagine it was this softness and his mind, which was forever bursting with ideas, that saw the birth of Mellow Circle way back in early 2000. Yes, it is Georgie who proposed the idea and saw it through. And here we are today, almost 23 years since the journey began and going strong. Some 10 years after the formation of Mellow Circle, I think it was after a trip overseas, we had a very excited Georgie amongst us, raving about a musical show he saw. And as was to be expected, he wanted to replicate the same here. This led to the birth of Mom, or the magic of music. With almost 120 strong, Mom 1 took the stage. A 50-member orchestra, a band, and a 60-member choir. Needless to say, the show was a huge hit, and we had Georgie beaming from year to year. Tough on the outside, but soft and mushy on the inside. That was Georgie. Ever since Meena's passing away, it was rumored that he would not sleep alone and that Tanush would keep him company. Leading to a very concerned Georgie, who once asked him, but he was also one who could call a spade, and didn't it matter to him who was around. If he wanted to speak his mind out, he would. Georgie was a thorough professional, with irrefutable integrity and trusted to deliver. No wonder then he continued to advise his previous employers, even after his departure from the company. If you watch Georgie closely, you could see that naughty glint in his eyes. One place where it was very evident was when we were celebrating one of our buddies' milestone events. If he was assigned to create the PowerPoint show on that person, often his comments on the photograph would leave even the most thick-skinned amongst us red in the face. Yes, he was a prankster, and a water one at that. Right now, he must be pulling some real fast ones on the angels up in heaven, making sure that there is never a dull moment. That was Georgie. Goodbye, my friend, till we meet again.
Georgie. He was indeed a director's delight. What with his abundant talent and a dhamaka package that he was, full of energy, full of life. I still recall almost 23 years ago acting in the play Born Today. And guess my role? I was Mary. And Georgie? Well, he was Satan. And my, he played it to the T. I remember how he air dashed to Chennai, memorized his lines, and was spot on during our practices. What fun we had. the audience would really hate a Satan like him. I mean his acting. But do you know that he could also melt hearts? Well, in the play The Fourth Wise Man, if I remember right, I still remember my tears welling up when he performed. In fact, he was walking around the stage with the hymn Beneath the Cross of Jesus sung in the background. My, what a touching scene. Moving the audience to tears. There can never be another George. His lines always well articulated and his talents abundant. More than anything else, a wonderful human being. Rest in peace, George.
It will be difficult to forget Georgie, aka George Thomas. I first met him in 1974. He was both part of the Holy Trinity Church Youth Fellowship and Choir. He sang tenor and I sang bass. Even in those days, he was an extremely friendly individual who was always the life of the party. Our choir used to perform at several programs and we all used to meet on Saturday afternoons for youth fellowship. The youth fellowship at that time was held at the Kirk Parsonage. We travelled to Andhra together to write entrance exams for medicine. I had a great time on this trip. I left for Mellow in 76 and returned to Chennai in 1993. After joining Sundar Medical Foundation, Georgie sent his daughter with his wife to meet me there for some medical problem. He was aware as to where everyone was. We met at reunions and get-togethers. He was not just the life of the party. He was also its soul. He brought in the element of caring and sharing for others. Georgie, you are always fresh in our memories.
Georgie, a year has gone by since we bade you goodbye. Time so quickly has flown. Not a day has gone past without your shadow being cast on memories that your life has sown. Georgie, on memories that your life has sown. Mellow meetings abounded. The choir resounded as your smile just wafted about. GCs were convened, grand plans were screened with your guidance when we are in doubt. Georgie, with your guidance when we are in doubt. Prathyasha smiles brightly. Oh, the kids are so lively. A new life your vision gave them. Whenever they pray, with folded hands they say, thank you for being a gem. Georgie, thank you for being a gem. Saturday nights go on, though a touch full on. Your presence is sorely missed. We know you look on like the days bygone, so we smile and get on with our whist. Georgie, we smile and get on with our whist. Georgie, you're a star in the night sky afar. How blessed your life has been. Bask in the glory of our Lord Almighty and soak in the love of your kin. Georgie, soak in the love of your kin. Till we meet again, dear mate, at heaven's pearly gate. we simply want you to know. We miss you a ton. Of a kind you are one. We thank God for making you so. We thank God for making you so. We thank God for making you so.
There are some who bring light so great to the world that even after they have gone, the light remains. Today, I stand in front of you all with a deep hole in my heart. And this is not just my heart, that as a whole, it is all of yours as well. I, on behalf of Mellow Circle, Prathyasha, I am honored to say a few words about our dearest departed Georgie on his first anniversary. I'm privileged to have spent my exciting social service life knowing Georgie from the year 2000. As founder of Mellow Circle, he has inspired all of us to do charity mixed with family fun and fellowship. A legend, he was a humble man full of love, patience, strength, encouragement, and a man who silently will bring so much joy and happiness to all of us. He was our mentor, and he is the one person whose encouragement we see in the birth of Prathyasha. His acting and fundraising skills has helped Prathyasha to grow so beautifully. We are always indebted to him and his family. Today we miss him deeply. We miss his words of wisdom. We miss his leadership. We miss him as a true friend. In life and now death, you won't want us to focus on the sadness. Instead, we cherish those lovely memories of Georgie. His hospitality is unimaginable. Till we meet again, Georgie, adios, amigo.
I wanted you for life, you and me in the wind. I never thought there'd come a time that our story would end. It's hard to understand, but I guess I'll have to try. It's not easy to say goodbye. For all the joy we shared, all that time we had to spend. Now if I had one wish, I'd want forever back again. To look into your eyes and hold you when you cry. It's not easy to say goodbye. I remember great times we had, so many memories, some good, some bad. Yes, and through it all, those memories will last forever. There's peace in where you are, maybe all I need to know. And if I listen to my heart, I'll hear your laughter once more. And so I have to say, I'm just glad you came my way. It's not easy to say goodbye.